Hi, I'm Pierrick from the Developer Relations team. In this video, I show how to build a custom chat app as a Google Workspace add-on with AppScript. As a demonstration, I built an out-of-office assistant that users can add to Spaces and Message. It displays help on how to use the app from a quick command and message from the user. It blocks out the day in calendar from a first quick command. And it sets an out-of-office auto-reply for the day in Gmail from a second quick command. To follow along, you need a Google Workspace account with access to Google Chat, AppScript, and Google Cloud Console. For your convenience, every step of the build has a dedicated chapter, so you can directly jump to what interests you in this video. The complete source code can be downloaded or cloned from the public GitHub repository, Google Workspace AppScript Sample. Or you can directly duplicate the public AppScript project we share as well. All interactive chat apps are event-based. Building one typically consists of developing event handlers. For example, a user initiates an action interacting with the chat app in chat, such as messaging it. Chat calls the event handler defined by the chat app for the event type. The chat app event handler executes and returns a response, such as sending a message with text and cut. In our case, we want to implement the event handlers using AppScript. Let's start by creating a standalone AppScript project. The first function we need is onAddedToSpace. It handles the event added to space where a chat app is added to a direct message, a group chat, or a namespace. Here, we want to reply with a card message that explains how to use the chat app. To achieve this, we add the help function to our project and returns the card to display. And we add a few utility functions to generate chat-specific response objects and messages from text and card. The function onMessage handles the event message where users message the app. Here we do the exact same thing as for the event added to space, and reply with a card message that explains how to use the chat app. The function onRemovedFromSpace is here for the event removedFromSpace, where a user removed the chat app from a space. We don't do much in this case, but log the event in the AppScript console. And the function onAppCommand handles the event AppCommand, where a user invokes an AppCommand, whether it is a quick command or a slash command. Each AppCommand has its own specific execution logic. You might have noticed that all functions have an event parameter. It provides contextual data, such as the user local, user email, space name, and timing information. And it provides payloads specific to the event types as well. For example, in the case of an app command event, it contains information about the app command being invoked. And that's how we can use a switch statement in the function onAppCommand to execute specific logic for specific app commands. By default, we do the exact same thing as for the events added to space and message. We reply with a card message that explains how to use the chat app. To handle the app command block dayout, we add the function block dayout to our project. It depends on the blackout calendar function that uses the calendar API to create an out of office event in the user's calendar. We do something similar for the app command set auto reply with the functions set auto reply and turn on autoresponder. But this time, the function turnOnAutoResponder uses the Gmail API to turn on the out-of-office responder in the user's Gmail instead. When a user invokes the app's commands, blockDayout or setAutoReply, our app displays a card to notify the user about the completion of the task they invoked. To achieve this, both app command handlers return the same response card built by the function createResponseCard. There is a text parameter to adapt the content to the specific tasks. And that's pretty much it when it comes to scripting. Now, let's see how we need to set the manifest in the project. The first thing to note is that we enable App Scripts advanced services for Gmail and Calendar. The chat app relies on them to call the Gmail and Calendar APIs whenever a user uses one of its commands. Next, we need to define the project as a Google Workspace add-on. It's done with the Add-ons field. Under Common, we are required to provide basic information about the add-on, such as its name and logo. And last but not least, we have to add the chat field under Add-ons, otherwise it will not be recognized as a chat app. A default Google Cloud project that operates in the background is automatically created when you create an app script project. For most projects, this is the best option. But it's necessary to manually configure the cloud project when building most add-ons, including a chat app. That's why we have to create and use a dedicated project in the Cloud Console in our case. After we create the Google Cloud project, we need to configure an OAuth consent screen. It's displayed to users when they install or first use the chat app. What we set under the app information will be displayed to the chat app users on the consent screen. We choose the internal option here because we only plan to use this chat app within our Google Workspace organization. Let's make sure we provide a valid email address under developer contact information for Google to notify us about any changes related to this cloud project. Since the chat app is for internal use, there is no need to specify the scopes for the consent screen. We are all set. After we configure an OAuth consent screen in the Google Cloud project, we can link it to our AppScript project. It's done by updating the AppScript project settings after copying the cloud project number from the Google Cloud Console. Now, do you remember that we rely on the Calendar and Gmail advanced services in our AppScript project? We have to enable the Calendar and Gmail APIs in our cloud project, otherwise they will fail calling them. Next thing to do is to enable the chat API in the cloud project. Once enabled, we can add the necessary information about the chat app in the configuration tab. This chat app is interactive and it's implemented with AppScript, so we specify it here. To link our AppScript project to the chat API, a deployment ID has to be set. At this point, we only want to deploy for testing purposes. The best is to use the head deployment ID of our Google Workspace add-on, so that all changes in the AppScript project will be automatically deployed. We would use a deployment ID for a specific version of the AppScript project if we were publishing to the Google Workspace marketplace though. We want to support three quick commands. For each, we have to specify the name and description to display in chat, and a unique technical ID. The IDs have to match those used in the implementation, or the chat app returns an error if the user tries to use one of its commands. The remaining fields are here to specify who to share this test version of the chat app with, and whether we want to enable Google Cloud logging. Let's not forget to save the configuration when done, and wait for the confirmation notification. Great! Now we are ready to start testing our chat app. Since we configured the chat app to be available to me, I'm able to search, find, and install it from Google Chat. Let me install it. The chat app asks for my permission to access Gmail and Calendar via the OAuth consent screen because we are using it for the first time. And I received the help message as expected after giving my consent. Now let me try using the chat app's quick commands we defined. As expected, the help quick command replies with the help message. The black day out quick command replies with the confirmation message after blocking out the day in my calendar. And the set auto reply quick command replies with the confirmation message after adding an out of office responder in my Gmail for the day. Looks like I'm ready to leave the office now. Well, not really. I'm not done just yet. Let me show you how we can extend a chat app built as a Google Workspace add-on to any other supported Workspace apps, such as Gmail, Calendar, Drive, Docs, Sheets, and Slides. The user interface and execution logic we developed for the chat app can be used to build a sidebar in the other Google Workspace apps. Help can be displayed as a homepage. Blocking out the day in calendar can be done from a first universal action. And setting an out-of-office auto-reply for the day in Gmail can be done from a second universal action. Now, let's define a new function on homepage that handles users loading the homepage. We reuse the function help here to return the card that explains how to use the add-on. And that's pretty much it when it comes to scripting. Now, let's see how we need to update the manifest in the project. Under Common, we have to add the homepage trigger field and set our handler function using run function to enable the homepage. We also need the universal actions field. Each universal action is defined with a label to display in the apps and a handler function. We want two universal actions in this case, to block day out and set auto reply. And last but not least, we need to add the fields calendar, Gmail, Drive, Docs, Sheets, and Slides under add-ons. Otherwise, it will not be recognized in any of these Workspace apps. From there, we go back to our test deployment settings and click Install. Great, we should be able to start testing with the newly supported Workspace apps. Let's try with Gmail. I see the Out of Office Assistant add-on is now available. I see the help card from the homepage in the sidebar after opening it. And I'm able to use the universal actions we defined. For example, the Black Day Out universal action pushes the confirmation card in the sidebar after blocking out the day in my calendar. I can switch to the calendar add-on and see the new event was actually created as expected. Looks like everything was set correctly. And that's it. We now have a chat app built as a Google Workspace add-on similar to what 1Password, Figma, Lucid, Miro, Poly, ServiceNow, and many organizations have. Do you want to learn more about chat apps, Google Workspace add-ons, AppScript, or how you can extend Workspace? I'm adding key resources here and in the video description for your convenience. I especially recommend subscribing to our YouTube channel and visiting our Google Workspace Developers website, where you can find quick starts, guides, references, samples, and much more. Thank you all for watching, and happy building!